The diffuse type of tenosynovial giant cell tumour is also known as pigmented villonodular synovitis, or PVNS. The localised type is also known as giant cell tumour of tendon sheath. Tenosynovial giant cell tumour may arise from synovial lining of joints, tendon sheaths and bursae. It is now accepted that tenosynovial giant cell tumour is a neoplastic lesion and not reactive. Diffuse tenosynovial giant cell tumour is slightly more frequent in females than males, and the most common location is the knee, accounting for approximately 80% of cases. It may also arise in the hip, ankle and foot. Symptoms include monoarticular arthritis, pain and locking. And the lesion may erode into bone and soft tissue, and importantly, it may recur following surgical excision. The gross appearance is of an orange, red or brown fronded mass, and histologically there is villous hypertrophy, sheets of proliferating synoviocyte-like cells with foamy macrophages, giant cells, and haemosiderin deposits, giving it the golden brown appearance, and also areas of sclerosis may be seen. This is the gross appearance of diffuse tenosynovial giant cell tumour, and you can see why it is also known as pigmented villonodular synovitis. It's pigmented and it's villous, and also nodular. In this area of the tumour, towards the centre of the picture, there are golden brown pigmented deposits, and this is haemosiderin. And here the haemosiderin has been stained with Perls Prussian blue. This is the histological appearance of the areas of villous hypertrophy. Here we see a collection of lymphocytes, foamy macrophages and multinucleate giant cells. And finally, here is an area of sclerosis.